You both fell out!
You want to hit your pants now? Huh? You want to hit your pants now? You want to put the little buckles
on the side? What do I tell you about pushing on a chair? We don't do it only.
It's loose for you all the way.
You nervous?
Yes.
Are you?
Yeah.
Should be.
Thanks, Tom.
All the time was depressing.
Don't look so happy.
Hey, Tom. Oh, was it a video?
Yep.
Oh, okay. I was doing a still pose.
Oh.
But I can move.
You guys ready?
Oh, yeah.
Are you all rehearsed? Do you know what
yes.
to do?
We know.
Do you know which way to walk?
We know which way to walk. We know how to walk. We
really?
Know who to walk with. We know which direction to go.
Really?
Yes.
That's good.
A little closer, Cameron. There you go. That's good. That's good.
Good. Thank you. I know you're getting tired.
When was the last time you saw Bonnie?
5 years ago.
Must be.
Yeah, I mean, I brought some tape.
2001.
Look at Aunt Holly, honey. Stop moving. Stop moving. Stop. Stay right there. Stay right there. Stop right there.
You can't just stop. I'm just going to stand here.
Cheryl, do you need candy?
Yep.
We need him to come.
Come on, babe, let's go. Aunt Holly will help you, okay?
Okay.
Wait just a minute while I reload.
Oh, this is such a beautiful setting.
Is it pretty big? I wonder if it's going to be too cold for you, Drew.
Oh, no. It feels awesome. Oh, bring on the cold. I'm like, bring it on. We are just so
hot. And I already corrected Kristen. And now I'm the one who's calling you Chuck. I'm sorry.
It's Charlie.
It's Charlie. It's Chuck. Is it Chuck or Charlie?
Are you Chris?
Come here.
I want mommies. I want mommies.
Okay. So what are we?
Here!
Don't give it to me.
Hey, I want Smarties.
Hey, Mommy.
I can't walk you.
No more
Smarties.
Your teeth are going to come
out. Yes, Mommy. My toes are tired.
Okay, then you sit and relax.
All right.
Good.
Okay,
Mommy. It's nice.
Everybody's
over here. Everybody's fine.
Slow down, Turbo.
Who knows if they even have? I don't think he's going to listen.
And put it back in the pocket.
It's a nice day.
You're welcome.
Start. Let me ask that all of you make sure that your cell phones are turned off or down so that we don't have any interruptions like that. But you are welcome to use your flash with your cameras. Let me begin with a reading from Mark 10, 6 through 9. But at the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, the man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man put asunder. We have gathered here today in the sight of God and in the love of friendship and family to celebrate the joining together of two lives. You have been invited here today to witness as Barry William Plunkett II and Amanda Beth Lancaster unite as one in holy matrimony. In the time they have been together, their love for and understanding of each other has grown and matured. Now they have decided to live their lives together as husband and wife. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
Thank you. You can all be seated now. Would you please bow with me as we ask the Lord's blessing on our time together today? Our Father in heaven, creator, savior, and designer of marriage, we turn to you this afternoon, asking that you be glorified by what takes place, that this ceremony would honor you and reflect the seriousness of the vows to be spoken. Might this service be a reminder to those who have spoken similar vows to their spouses in the past? Might it be instructive to those yet considering such a commitment in their future? Might this ceremony be a fitting beginning for Barry and Amanda as they commit themselves before you and this company to pursue a long and happy life together as husband and wife? We ask these things in your name. Amen. Barry and Amanda, you realize that in a greater sense, no other person or officiant can truly marry you. Only you can marry yourselves. By your commitment to love each other, to work together with all your hearts toward creating an atmosphere of care and respect, and by your willingness to face together the fears and uncertainty that underlie human life, you marry yourselves much more surely than any doubting of each other's needs. The joy and comfort you bring to your hearts, and the happiness you bring to your souls. Today, you commit yourselves to honoring and protecting one another above your separate selves, and to valuing your union above your own interests. In so doing, you will find a wealth of love and peace not otherwise attainable. But with this joy, comes a profound responsibility to protect the bond that you share. For it is only with continual care that your love is truly secure in the face of life's inevitable tests. You must regard each other with the deepest respect. You must appreciate each other's talents, foster each other's dreams, and be ever mindful of the many gifts the other offers you. You must inspire and encourage one another, for by strengthening your partner, you strengthen your marriage. Be sparing in criticism and generous in praise for things well done. Although you will at times disagree, remember to respect each other's feelings, needs, and wants. And most importantly, bring out the very best in each other. Do all these things, and more, because of your endless love for each other. Let me share some thoughts Paul wrote of love long ago in his letters to the Corinthians. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. Within the Bible, nothing is of more importance than love. God is love. And we are assured that love conquers all. It is love which brings you here today. It is love that will make this a glorious union. And it is love that will cause this union to endure. And as time goes on, you may want to reflect back on that passage from Corinthians. That, of course, is not exactly the way Paul wrote it back then. It's been modernized. You can make it even more modern in reminding yourself of your vows. Go back and replace the words love with your names. Barry is patient. Amanda is kind. Barry is not rude. Amanda is not self-seeking. Those can be really easy reminders for you in the future of the importance of that passage. A vast, unknown future stretches out before you. That future, with its hopes and its disappointments, its joys and its sorrows, is hidden from your eyes. but it is a great tribute to your belief in each other that you are willing to face those uncertainties together. May God bless you and this union, and may the pure, simple love with which you join hearts and hands today never fail, but grow deeper and surer with every year you spend together. Barry, I require you to promise to love and cherish Amanda, to honor and sustain her in sickness and in health, in poverty as in wealth, in bad that may darken your days, in the good that may lighten your ways, and to be true to her in all things until death alone shall part you. Do you so promise?
I do.
Then repeat after me. I, Barry, take you, Amanda.
I, Barry, take you, Amanda.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Amanda, I require you to promise to love and cherish Barry, to honor and sustain him, in sickness and in health, in poverty as in wealth, in bad that may darken your days, in the good that may lighten your ways, and to be true to him in all things until death alone shall part you. Do you so promise? And you repeat after me. I, Amanda, take you, Barry, to be my lawfully wedded husband. To have and to hold, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, as long as we both shall live. For thousands of years, lovers have exchanged rings as a token of their vows. These simple gold bands are not of great value in themselves, but are made precious by our wearing of them. The ring is a symbol not only of the meaning you both have for it, but a symbol for the outside world that you are committed in marriage with another human being. Let these rings be a sign that love has a past, a present, and a future, and that despite its occasional sorrows, love is a circle of joyous wonder and delights. Barry, Amanda's ring, put it on her finger. And repeat after me. Just as this circle is without end.
Just as this circle is without end.
My love for you is never ending.
My love for you is never ending.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I take you to be my wife. And now you repeat after me. Just as this circle is without end, my love for you is never ending. With this ring, I take you to be my husband. There are many traditions and rituals commonly included in marriage ceremonies. One of the most beautiful and expressive is the unity candle. Two fires, separate and individual, uniting their flames to burn as one. Imagine how you might describe fire to someone who had never experienced it before. It is difficult to say what it is because it is both substance and energy at the same time. The best you might do is to say that there is always plain evidence of it when it exists, and that you can feel its warmth. Love, similarly, would be hard to describe to someone who had never experienced it before, except to say that there is always a visible evidence of it when it exists, and you can feel its warmth. As a symbol of the union of their separate selves, Barry and Amanda will now light the unity candle. Thank you. Would you bow your heads and pray with me one more time? Dear Heavenly Father, our hearts are filled with great joy on Barry and Amanda's wedding day as they come before you, pledging their hearts and their lives to one another. Grant that they may be ever true and loving, living together in such a way as to never bring shame or heartbreak into their marriage. Temper their hearts with kindness and understanding. Rid them of all pretense of jealousy. Help them to remember to be each other's sweetheart, helpmate, friend, and guide, so that together they may meet the cares and problems of life more bravely. And with the passage of time, may the home they are creating today truly be a place of love and harmony where your spirit is ever present. Bless this union, we pray, and walk beside Barry and Amanda throughout all their lives together. We ask these things in your name. Amen. Inasmuch as you have sealed your vows in the presence of God and this company by the giving of these rings, and have consented together to live in marriage by the authority committed to me as an ordained minister, and according to the laws of the state of Michigan, it gives me great pleasure to pronounce that you are now husband and wife. Would you like to kiss your bride? Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome, for the first time, newlyweds, Barry and Amanda Plunkett.
Hugs and kisses and love. Where's my... Fellas, ready? Here we go. One.